Roman dialect, cynical Roman humor, continuous cultural references, and the eastern suburbs of Rome in the background. Interior along the dotted line, cartoonist Cyrical Curry brings his entire world and language to the screen to tell an intimate and personal story, which through sarcasm and introspection addresses a universal message. The animated series, broadcast on Netflix in more than 150 countries, has been translated into several languages, and thanks to the dubbing, its message could reach even the most geographically and culturally distant people. But is it really possible to preserve cultural elements and make sense of linguistic nuances without making the foreign audience feel alienated? Will this one be able to be moved to laugh and reflect just as much as the Italian one did? In attempting to clear any distance and give the illusion that the language heard is the native language of the series, it is likely that translators and adapters incur the risk of overshadowing the original culture, generating a cultural distortion or a cultural flattening. The dialogue adapter, therefore, must bridge the gap between the two cultures, without ever losing sight of the original content and spirit of the audiovisual product. In this perspective, audiovisual adaptation, which has to take into account all the cultural aspects, verbal and non-verbal ones, should be seen as a process of negotiation in which additions and losses are crucial to achieve a balance between fidelity to the source text and adaptation for the target audience. In this regard, different strategies can be followed, such as foreignization and domestication, the former aiming to preservation of culturally specific elements, and the latter to greater accessibility for the new audience. For example, in this scene from Tear Along the Dotted Line, the reference to Renata Zero and Zecchino d'Oro will not necessarily be understood by the target audience. The adaptation for the English dubbing opted for a foreignization, choosing to leave the reference to the singer unchanged and to generalize the reference to the music festival with the expression "it goes on TV." In contrast, the French one made the references more familiar, replacing Renata Zero with the French singer Mathieu Chedid and quoting L'École des Fans, a cult French television program. A distortion that responds to the desire to reproduce the humor of the scene in a more immediate way. The comic humor aspect made the adaptation of the series particularly tricky, with missions and neutralizations in both languages. Mainly because it is conveyed through abundant use of diatopically marked variants, swear words, puns, as well as frequent changes of registers. The Roman dialect, which permeates every scene becoming the protagonist, is certainly among the most challenging factors in translation. Although it can be considered as a proper dialect, it aims to render with frankness and simplicity the state of mind of Zero, the protagonist, masking through comedy bitter reflections on society and on human existence. The translations of expressions and interjections typical of Rome, which may have various meanings depending on the intention and on the context, may result in the loss of nuances of meaning, generate semantic misunderstandings, and risking to elicit in the target audience an effect which is different from the one desired by the author. In fact, in the analysis of English and French adaptation, in most cases, the French version is more likely to adopt solutions that are closer to the original in terms of register and communicative effectiveness. As it is the case in this line, in English, it was decided to use the expression "to feel resentful" to translate the Roman verb rosicare, an appropriate but neutral choice which fails to fully convey the complexity of emotions ranging between helplessness and anger in an equally ironic tone. The French version made a bolder choice, using a vulgar expression belonging to the argot, the French slang, foutre les boules. Although it is not possible to convey the Romanness of the term, it has managed to differentiate with the rest through a more colloquial register. An audiovisual product is a particularly complex semiotic system consisting of a variety of codes, visual, sound, and verbal. For this reason, great attention must be paid to the nonverbal aspects, particularly to the sound component and the visual constraint. What the viewer hears must not betray what the viewer sees on the screen. To conclude, adapting a film or a series does not necessarily mean putting a blindfold on the viewer when there are elements that are foreign to their culture, but providing them with the linguistic means to perceive the foreign without making them feel alienated. For this, the word compromise is crucial, because perfect equivalence in translation doesn't exist, but quoting Umberto Eco, one can try to say almost the same thing. The English and French adaptation of Tearing Along the Dotted Line succeeded in transforming these apparent barriers into bridges that the more distant viewer was able to cross, exploring Ciro Calcari's world and experiencing that existential discomfort that everyone feels as attempting to tear along the dotted line of life.